Hello everybody, this is Denise, Something Beautiful Handcrafts, and I'm hoping that this is like not the worst view ever, trying to get everything all in the picture, but I am working on a pocket scarf, or at least that's the plan, that it should have a pocket. Okay, so right now this is my Ladybug spinning wheel, if you're not familiar with it, and on the spinning wheel I have a combination of British Suffolk and Dorset. So what I did was I have one ball of Dorset on this side and one ball of Suffolk. And what it was that I needed a certain amount of yardage and I did not want to completely card up a pound of Cheviot, which I really could have done. And so I do have one skein of Cheviot already over here from some other project I did, which I can't remember. And I kind of went through all my rovings and saw what I had on hand. And I needed something that was going to be machine washable for the most part. So the down breeds, like the Suffolk, the Dorset, the Hampshire, and Cheviot is really a hill breed, are fairly felt resistant. They're often referred to as nature superwash. Now, they will felt, but it takes a lot of heat and agitation. So for the most part, you can carefully machine wash these guys. Now, I'm saying carefully, and I'm putting that preface on that. So I figured this is the best material, wool, for me to use for this project, for this. Basically, it's going to be a barn scarf, so it really does need to be as easy to clean as possible. So with those two different combinations of wools, and they were already in roving, they're fairly similar. And so I just decided to ply the two different ones. And this was as much as I could get on the first bobbin. And I sent this through the circular knitting machine just to check to see how much I would need. And this is the combination. So what I'm actually going to do is I'm plying up the second bobbin. And then I'm going to use the Cheviot as well. And that should be enough for me to complete the pocket scarf. And then I'm going to go ahead and unravel this one because I just needed it for my calculations. And I'm going to dye it in the dye studio at Praxis. A nice blue and yellow for a friend. And then I'm going to go ahead and crank it again on the machine and add the pockets to it. So you'll be able to get a preview of it before it's sent off with the pockets attached to it. Now, if you haven't seen those pocket shawls, I think they're like all the rage on Pinterest. You can go ahead and look that up. They're really neat. And now that I have the circular knitting machine, which was a nice investment, it turns out, by the way. I'm doing a video on the circular knitting machine. I am able to produce these a lot faster. And it saves my hands, which is the whole goal here, because I get tendonitis pretty frequently and have for some years now. This will save my hands. Now, usually, as I've said, if you've ever seen my YouTube videos, I don't do anything this close to the orifice. But for the sake of the angle of the video, I am plying closer so that you can see me in the frame. But I like to make it a nice smooth action. And for the ladybug, I do always feel like I am adjusting the tension. For the luette, the tension was so high on that machine, I hardly did anything until the bobbin was extremely full. Then I had to use the brake band. but it does seem for the ladybug that I'm always adjusting tension when I am in Scotch drive. That is not the case in double drive, but I don't do a lot of spinning in double drive, and not on this wheel. The Country Craftsman is completely in double drive, and so when I'm spinning on that, it just has a totally different feel to it, and I prefer the Scotch tension on the ladybug itself. Okay, and it's the quick changing hooks. Yes, I could get a woolly winder, but I kind of like the break in the spinning that it gives me to change hooks. And when I'm not gabbing on the video, I can pretty much do it as fast as I need to do, just kind of change and keep moving. So it doesn't slow me down any not to have a woolly winder. And basically that's what I'm doing for Maker Monday.